there. Hustle on over. I'm Lucas Baramsko, but everyone knows me as Gilly. I've served in 6 squadrons and qualified on almost a dozen ships. So if you put in the time, I'll get you on the path to dogfighting with the best of them. We're gonna set you up in the ship on the landing pad to your right. Hustle over and let's get going. Move it, move it, move it! First things first, take a look around your cockpit and familiarize yourself with the layout. It's imperative to quickly find and access specific controls. Last thing you want to be doing in a scrap is bringing up the instructions. You'll notice the majority of your systems are disabled. I'll be controlling when they're on and offline to simulate potential scenarios and combat situations. Let's get ready for takeoff. I'll do this step by step to show you how it's done. Look over at me and watch what I do. Systems, check. Engines, check. Tower, permission for launch.
Cleared for launch.
Copy that, tower. All right, first I want to lift vertically until I'm just clear of the landing pad. Now that I'm clear, I can straight forward onto the taxiway. Now I square my ship up with the ceiling doors, ready for a vertical takeoff. Once you're aligned, the tower will open the doors. That's it. Once I clear out, it'll be your turn. Ready? I'm enabling your systems. We'll monitor your progress from up here.
Launch complete.
Contact.
Nice. You're clear of the pad. Okay, now straight forward onto the taxiway. If you need it, the tower should have lit up your path. Make sure you don't pitch or roll. It'll be tough to get back into proper alignment. Don't align yourself with the middle of the doors. You'd be surprised how many crews forget that the cockpit is not the center of the ship. The tower will open the doors once you're lined up. You're lined up. Alignment's looking solid. That's a good line, pilot. Great job. I haven't seen many pull one off on the first try. I've just enabled your targeting system. Use it to target me. Good. When pursuing a target, you'll want to keep your speed as close to theirs as possible. Give it a shot. Make sure I'm targeted and hit match speed. Great, you're locked on. Remember, this is an autopilot, so you still have to steer. But you'll notice that once you're locked, your computer will continue to monitor my speed and adjust. It doesn't matter if I speed up slowly or stop fast. That, my friend, is the Spire. Isn't she a beauty? Moving on. Now this is my favorite part of training, the axial roll. So much fun. Rolling is a great way to orient your ship to fit through tight gaps or evade incoming fire. Now you give it a go. Nice one. Well, you seem to be able to handle your ship, so let's see if you can handle a bit of combat. Should have a contact. Don't worry, it's just a training drone. It handles just like the real thing, but its weapons are less than lethal. Saying that, they still pack a punch, so try not to take any hits if you don't have to. Use your targeting system to quickly target the closest enemy. Okay, now look at the top right of your HUD. You should see the target displayed. This will show real-time damage, shield status, and a few other things. Shields are drawn as panels floating around the ship. They'll shrink as they weaken until they disappear completely. At that point, your shots will hit the hull and cause lasting damage. Now your weapons are online. Line up your target and fire when you're ready. Good shot. See its shields weakening on your HUD? Yeah, it didn't like that. What are you waiting for? Go finish it off. Now you have a target. You'll have extra aim reticules. Those are predicted impact points, or pips. They'll show you where to shoot to hit a moving target. Notice you have multiple pips with varying lag. Each of those indicates a weapon on your ship. The computer's trying to compensate for the varying speeds between your ballistic and energy projectiles. Taking hits. Check your HUD for shield and damage status.
Shields up.
Good hit. Keep firing. There you go. Keep on the pressure. The shields are down. Finish it off with a missile. Missile locking sensors are on the nose, so keep your target in front of you long enough to lock on. Launch!
Lock.
You have a lock. Lock! Fire!
Missile. Lock. Missile locked. Proximity alert port. Missile locked.
Good kill. On me, rookie.
Contact. Begin scan. Proximity alert. Head. Proximity alert. Head.
On me! Let's go! Waiting on you, kid. Let's move on. Uh-oh!
Contact.
Looks like he had a friend. Take a look in your rearview camera. He's got lock. Missiles incoming.
Proximity alert. Starboard shield.
He's got lock. Missiles incoming. That hit took out your weapons. You'll have to hold out till they come back. Countermeasures are still online. Use them. Last missile was heat-seeking, so equip your flares. Helpful tip, don't boost after dropping one. Boosted thrusters are much hotter than a flare. Flares have a short lifetime. Don't be too quick to fire them. Shields. Another pro tip, countermeasures are fired backwards, so never fly a missile head-on, launch countermeasure, and expect it to work. Good, you got your guns back, but I'll need more time to get your missiles up. If the drone gets behind you, enter decoupled mode to disengage your main engines and allow you to spin your ship around while retaining your original vector.
Alert. Starboard shield under fire.
It's a great way to dissuade your pursuer, but make sure you've checked your path ahead first. Give it a try. Just remember to disengage when you're done. Taking hits. Check your HUD for shield and damage status. He's got lock. Missiles incoming.
Shields recharging.
He's got lock. Missiles incoming. You got your missiles back. Take it out.
Missile locked.
Good kill. We're heading back to the landing pad to restock and refuel for the final part of your training. On me, rookie. You did good back there, kid. Let me guess, you're an Arena Commander fan. This should be close enough. Once landing mode's active, your HUD's gonna swap out your combat systems for landing-specific functionality. Go ahead and pick a landing pad. Once you've targeted a landing pad, request permission to land. Go ahead and pick a landing pad. Your radar is replaced by the landing system. It'll guide you to your pad and help you perform a safe landing. You can use the automatic ETL landing procedure or do the whole thing manually. Make sure your ship stays within the bounds of the pad and keep your eye on your pitch and roll.
Automated landing initiated. Manual landing initiated. Automated landing initiated. AP activated. Landing gear deployed. Landing complete.
Touchdown. Great work. While we're waiting, feel free to take a look at your ship's setup. In there, you'll see your weapon groups, shield configuration, and power distribution. I wouldn't mess around with them during training. Top. Let's get back out there. Take off when you're ready.
Landing gear retracted.
Think you can stay on my tail? If you need to get up to top speed in a hurry, try boosting. You can also use it to overpower your maneuvering thrusters in order to take tighter corners. You have a limited amount that takes time to replenish, so don't go nuts with it. If you need to cut your speed in a hurry, use your space brake. It's much quicker than dialing back your engines, and the moment you let go of it, you'll automatically accelerate back up to your previous speed. These ships aren't cheap. Watch it, rookie. Think you can put all this together? Let's see. Watch it, rookie. Keep up, kid. You're blowing it. What the hell's wrong with you? On me, rookie. Careful! These ships aren't cheap. What the hell's wrong with you? On me, rookie. Let's go, let's go. I'm falling asleep here. You're gonna give up now? Come on, push yourself! Still with me, kid? Good job. Now, one thing you need to understand, every ship's outfitted with systems to look out for you. That last sharp turn, you probably felt your ship clamp down on the speed. That's your G-safe system kicking in, making sure that you aren't taking too many G-forces and blacking out. If you need to get that extra edge in turning, you can disable G-safe, but be warned, an unconscious pilot turns to a dead one pretty quick. Keep up, kid. You're blowing it. Let's go, let's go. I'm falling asleep here. You're gonna give up now? Come on, push yourself. Think fast. Keep up, kid. You're blowing it. Let's go, let's go. I'm falling asleep here. Still with me? All right. I'm a little impressed. Race you to the spire. Hold on. I've got contacts inbound. Contact. Bando fighter. Dead ahead. This is not a drill. I repeat, this is not a drill. All your systems are active. This is a live fire encounter. Mark your target. You're taking hits. Check your HUD for shield and damage status. You're taking a lot of hull damage. Try to keep a shield between you and your enemy. Controlled bursts. Give your weapons time to cool, or they'll overheat. On me, rookie. Stay sharp. We've got more hostiles inbound. Looks like there's a glaive in the mix. That glaive's a recognized ace. Enemy designation is tank. We're gonna have to work together to take it down. Target the glaive. Gotta mark a target, kid.
Major, system overheating.
Ease up. Your weapons are getting hot.
Major, system overheating. Missile locked.
Kill. Glaive's down. You're clear to engage the rest. Good luck. You're clear to engage the rest. Good luck.
Depleted. Missile lock. Missile drive. Flare drop. Kill.
We're clear.
Contact.
Hell of a training session, huh?
Danger. Radiation critical.
I'm getting erratic power spikes from your ship. They must have hit your power plant. Your ship's loaded with military intel, so we can't let it fall into enemy hands. You'll have to initiate self-destruct before you eject.
Eject. Eject. Self-destruct. Initiated.
Come on, bail out!
Ejecting.
Get out of there! Cutting it close there, kid.
Let's get you back to base. First round's on me.